Well, this is Victor Osimhen. In 2016, as a leader of the under 20 national team, I met Victor Osimhen for the very first time. Osimhen was part of the under 17 team that won the World Cup in 2015. So it was my first time to meet him in 2016, and of course, immediately I saw this young man, I told the NFL then that forget Igalo, forget the strikers in the national team. We have got a striker coming up, and this man will take over Nigerian football. I was so sure that Victor Osimhen was the next big thing in Nigerian football, and I'm happy today that today Victor Osimhen is the best player in Africa. Thanks so much, Victor Osimhen, my player. So, Osimhen, I'm happy that the journey so far so good. You've been wonderful. I'm so impressed with your performance, and I believe that the sky is your limit. Osimhen, tell me the journey so far, the Super Eagles. I mean, when you came into the Super Eagles, there were some strikers, but suddenly you are the best striker in the national team. Tell us how it's the journey so far. How did you
I say it's a huge privilege to play for the Super Eagles, you know, to put on the jersey and represent Nigeria. And I remember when I came, a big thank you to Raw that gave me the opportunity to come into the team and to get me into the team slowly. And then big shout out to Odio Nigalo for his advice, for his words of encouragement. During the trying times up to now that I'm speaking to you. I think to be able to come into the Super Eagles and meet someone like me, you know, I think for me it's a big inspiration, and it's someone that I love and respect so much up to this day. And I remember when I came, the crazy situation, I remember when I came, it was new to me, and then I was 5 minutes late. So I was calling one of the guys to bring the key for me to open to take my boot because I was outside. And then Galo saw me and he was screaming at me, people give me the key that I need to go to my room and take my boot. And he actually waited for me to make sure that I get my boot and he come with me. And after, when the coach was like, why am I late? And he told the coach that because he had to wait for them to bring the key. So he's like a big brother to me. He's someone that I love and respect. And I wouldn't lie, if my success with the Super Eagles so far so good, Galo has been involved in someone that really pushed me a lot. And I'm happy that I was able to take all this advice from him and work hard to make sure I collect my team. Talk to me man for the Super Eagles. Of course, I think my dream to play for the Super Eagles has been accomplished. I'm really happy about it, and we have a long way to go, and I'm really looking forward to what the future has.
So, I mean, many experiences are going to play Guinea, and then along the line, Guinea were able to find a way from my back. I was going to play Cameroon. So, we are playing Cameroon on Saturday, and then it's going to be a good one. That's a battle, of course, you know, Nigeria versus Cameroon. We had that at the end of the years. Are you one of those who think that perhaps you should have played Guinea, or you are not scared of anything?
I'm not scared of anything. I'll be honest. I'm really not scared of anything. You know, I give respect to everything that I've made, that I've met since I joined the Super Eagles. Be it the underdogs, be it the big dogs. I'm not scared of anything. I don't think anything scares me. We're going to play 11 against 11. We're going to fight for every ball. Then if you win, you win. If I win, I won. So for me, it's normal. We get Guinea or we get Cameroon. It doesn't change the fact that we want to progress in this tournament. We want to go as well as winning it. But we cannot deny the quality we have. From the goalkeeper to the midfield to the attackers, the core qualities. But of course, I think we are the most talented group in AFCON. I think no team can compare themselves to us individually. So for me, I don't mind anything we play. I'm not scared of anything, but it's going to be a tough battle. and I'm really ready, and I think the boys also are ready.
There's a young man in the Cameroon in the Cameroon national team that played with you at Napoli. His name is Ngusa. Fantastic midfielder. I like seeing him move with the ball. So he's going to be in the tip of the park, and then of course coming against the Nigerian midfielders. I'm happy to know that Alassane Youssouf is back in the team. And do you think that the key battle in this match against Cameroon will be in the midfield?
I think Alassane back into the team is a huge boost for us.
Yeah.
We know what he can do. But of course, I think Ambisa also is one of the the world right now. I think he's got a lot of quality. We have to be used for himself. But I think we also have amazing strikers, amazing midfielders, the talented one. He will be there, he will do the damage. Amazing assist to us, the attackers. But I think it's going to be an interesting game. It's going to be a really interesting game. And I'm really looking forward to it. It'll be a tough battle. And of course, I wish my team all the very best too. And I think we're going to give our all to it.
Well, now we come to the Nations Cup. It's been three matches. We've won two, we drew one. And along the line, I know that by now, Osimhen will have 5 goals. Some of your goals are not coming. What is happening?
Yeah, you know, as a striker, there are some times the balls are not going in.
Yeah.
Not that you're not doing so well for yourself, but for the team. But yeah. Sometimes the balls are not just going in.
Do you think you are eager to score something or not?
No, it's still the same mentality, still the same mindset that I have even growing up and everything like that. But most of the time as a striker, you go 6-7 games not scoring, and then you go for the next 15 games, you're scoring, including with assists and everything like that. So for me, it's normal. The most important thing right now in the AFCON is for the team to continue to progress. I'm doing a lot for the team, I'm giving my all, to see, you know. But of course, a lot of people say, oh, he missed chances, he didn't score. For me, I don't care. I have to be honest, for me, I really don't care. Because even though I'm on the bench, I will still keep the same mentality to the boys, because we have also Murphy is there, you know, Omarchi is there that can get a job done. For me, I think I'm a team player, I don't care. If I'm not scoring, if I have just one goal in 3 games, I honestly don't mind. The team is progressing, we are doing so well, we are in the northern state. There's a big game coming up again. We just want to go through to the second round. Victor didn't put himself first before the team come first. If I choose to put myself there in terms of wanting to score and everything like that, I will not let the captain to play the band. I will do it myself. Even though I miss the band, we keep it moving. I keep it moving. People will say what they need to say, they will talk what they need to talk. I do not care. But to me, I'm a team player. But I think for me, the most important thing now in this tournament is for Nigeria to do well to get to the final as well as winning. My goals will come when it's time for them to come. But for now, I am not bothered. I think for me, I'm not stressed about it. I have to be honest, I'm really not stressed about it.